المبدئ المعيد المغني الحميد ذي العفو الواسع والعقاب الشديد من هداه فهو السعيد السديد ومن أضله فهو الشقي البعيد ومن أرشده إلى سبيل النجاة ووقاه فهو الرشيد يعلم ما ظهر وما بطن وما خفي وما علن وهو أقرب إلى كل مريد من حبل الوريد قسم الخلائق قسمين ففريق في الجنة وفريق في السعير نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يدخلنا الجنة وإياكم وأن يعيذنا من النار اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه الغر الميامين ومن سلك نهجه وسنته إلى يوم الدين أما بعد عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي الخاطئة بتقوى الله عز وجل فاتقوا الله سبحانه وتعالى في السر وفي العلن يقول مولى عز وجل في محكم تنزيله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون واعلموا أن أحسن الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد عباد الله إن الله سبحانه وتعالى خلق الجنة وجعلها داراً لأوليائه وأصفيائه وملأها من رحمته وكرامته ورضوانه ورغب فيها ودعا إليها وسماها دار السلام والله يدعو إلى دار السلام دار لا ينفد نعيمها ولا يبيد دار فيها من كل خير مزيد دار أشرق بهاؤها وطاب فناؤها وعظم بناؤها وبناؤها لبنة من ذهب ولبنة من فضة وملاتها المسك الأذفر وحصباؤها اللؤلؤ الجوهر وترباتها الزعفران من يدخلها ينعم ولا يبأس ويخلد ولا يموت لا تبلى ثيابهم ولا يفنى شبابهم وهي دار حولها ندندن فيا سعادة ساكنيها ويا سعادة وفوز وارثيها إخوة الإيمان لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون تفكروا إخوة الإيمان في نعيم الجنة في رواية ما رواه الإمام المسلم والبخاري في سند صحيح سأل موسى ربه عز وجل ما أدنى أهل الجنة منزله قال هو رجل يجيء بعدما أدخل أهل الجنة الجنة فيقال له أدخل الجنة فيقول يا رب كيف وقد نزل الناس منازلهم وأخذوا أخذاتهم فيقال له أترضى أن يكون لك مثل ملك ملك من ملوك الدنيا فيقول رضيت يا رب فيقول لك ذلك ومثله 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 فيقول في الخامسة رضيت يا رب فيقول هذا لك وعشرة أمثاله ولك ما اشتهت أنفسك ولك ما اشتهت نفسك ولذت عينك فيقول رضيت يا رب فقال ربي يا رب فأعلاهم منزلة فقال أولئك الذين أردت وغرست كرامتهم بيدي وختمت عليها فلم تر عين ولم تسمع أذن ولم يخطر على قلب بشر قال ومصداق قوله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين جزاء بما كانوا يعملون نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يجعلنا من أهل الجنة الفردوس الأعلى إذ قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فإذا سألتموه الجنة فاسألوه الفردوس الأعلى Dear brothers, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we exalt Him, we glorify Him, we sanctify Him and purify Him from all kind of shortcomings and the weakness, from all kind of shirk and the people of the shirk, from all kind of naqs that doesn't go with Allah's majesty and His honor. We send salat and salam upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, maw'iduna al-yawm مع الجنة. Today our topic would be about the Jannah. the everlasting pleasure. The reason of choosing this khutbah today, my dear brothers, because the Bani Adam, they need motivation. When you do the degrees, you try your best to achieve the higher. A plus in a GCSE, in A level, in a university level, in a graduation level, in the master, PhD, everywhere. We need to achieve the maximum result that we can gain, so that we can secure the best livelihood in this dunya, the best of the jobs, and the best of the salary. Similarly, my dear brothers, to go to the Jannah, we have to do the best in this dunya of the actions, of the righteous actions. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said one of the authentic hadith, when you ask Allah for the Jannah, just don't ask Allah for the lowest level of the Jannah. فَاسْأَلُوهُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ الْأَعْلَىٰ. Ask the highest level of the Jannah. Because فَإِنَّهُ أَوْسَتُهُ وَأَعْلَاهُ وَمِنْ فَوْقِهِ عَرْشُ الرَّحْمَنِ وَمِنْهُ تَفَجَّرَ أَنْهَارُ الْجَنَّةِ. Because the Jannah al-Firdaus is the top and in the middle of the Jannah. And above the al-Firdaus al-A'la is the Arsh al-Rahman, the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from that, the rivers of the Jannah flows down. So Jannah is the highest of the heaven of the earth, on the highest level. And the Jahannam in the Sijjin, in the lowest level, after the seven earth. We are in the first earth. There's the second, and the third, and the fourth, and the fifth, and the sixth. And then underneath the seventh is the Sijjin, the prison for the criminals, for the Mujrimun. So Jannah is always higher. So if you aim and target to achieve something, target something higher level in this dunya. In this dunya, my dear brothers, it is practical. You know, when fast, and especially the youngsters, they will know, when the first game, so-called game station, the PlayStations, Nintendo came out in the supermarket, the boys, they're thinking, they're getting crazy. If I cannot buy this, my life and the existence of the life will be valueless. As if he had this PlayStation, he'll be in the peak of the happiness. And then he's chasing behind it. And then when he gets the PlayStation, he just, as if he's flying on the earth. Out of the happiness, he feels my purpose of the dunya is now completed. And now a few months after he came, a Super Nintendo. Now what was yesterday his happiness and the peak of the happiness, today it became misery. Because he sees his friend playing Super Nintendo, and I am Nintendo. So this is the happiness of the dunya. Today this is happiness, you see, tomorrow is misery. And then he buys the Super Nintendo, few months after, now come Nintendo 64. Now the happiness of the peak of the happiness now became again misery. Until he buy that one. And this is bila nihaya, without any ending. This is how is the dunya. There is no such thing called pure happiness. All are fake. Contaminated. Contaminated, everything contaminated. From the food that we eat, from the drink that we drink, from the dress that we wear, from the house that we build, from the car that we drive. First time you bought the car, remember everybody who passed the driving, and the first time you bought the car, and maybe this is one of the most crappiest car you bought in the first time, because everybody do like this. But as if he's driving like he's driving limousine, you know, the way happiness he has. And next time he upgrade and upgrade, his happiness never ends, never finish. So the happiness of the dunya that we go through up there, around the dunya, is actually misery, is not happiness. It's not happiness. And this is exactly everything. How many times you upgraded your iPhones? How many times? Did you get your happiness yet? You'll never get the happiness. But the happiness of the Jannah, subhanallah, will never diminish. The happiness and the pleasure and the bounties of the Jannah is infinite, everlasting. 70 years goes by, million years goes by, trillion years goes by, he's still in the Jannah. And day after day, his jamal and his beauty increases, never decreases. Abdullah ibn Salam, one of the greatest sahabi, he narrated an authentic hadith, that when you pick up a fruit from the Jannah, from his branch, When you pick up one fruit from the Jannah, عيدت مكانها أخرى. And from that place, another fruit will come. And the next one is more tastier and more sweeter than the one previous you have. And this is what Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he informed us in one authentic hadith in the Bukhari and Muslim. When the people of the Jannah will go and gather in the day of judgment in the mahshar, and the people of the Jahannam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell, فَيُؤْتَى بِأَهْلِ الْنَارِ, and the man from the Jahannam will be brought forth. فَيُغْمَسُ فِي النَّارِ غَمْسَ, and that man of the hellfire, which Allah decreed for him hellfire for his action, the shirk with Allah in the dunya, and the crime that he committed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be telling the angel, اغْمِسُ غَمْسَةً فِي النَّارِ, dip him into the fire for just a moment, just a second. And after dipping him in the hellfire, when he will be brought forth before Allah, and Allah will be asking him, Ya Abdi, هَلْ مَرَّ بِكَ نَعِيمٌ قَطْ, O my slave, ever you experienced any kind of pleasure and the blessing? How many iPhone you changed? It's from myself I'm saying, Allah, I'm not going to ask you. How many iPhone you changed? How many upgrades you did? How many cars you changed? How many houses you built? All this pleasure, beautiful wife you had, everything you had, and the partner you salary was 60,000-70,000 a year. All this pleasure you enjoyed, and you disobeyed Allah and His Messenger day and night. After you being dipped in the hellfire for a second, do you remember those pleasure? He'll be replying to Allah, Ya Rabbi, ma marra bi na'imun qatt. Qatt means never. Ya Allah, I never ever experienced or passed by any kind of pleasure in the dunya ever. This 1 second of the punishment of the hellfire will make you forget everything that you enjoyed. كَأَنَّهُمْ لَمْ يَلْبَثُوا فِيهَا إِلَّا عَشِيَّةً أَوْ ضُحَاهَا. When they will see real picture of the day of judgment, it will be appeared to them as if they didn't live in the dunya, the time in the morning or time in the evening, for a few hours. As if the whole 100 years that he lived in the dunya, as if he lived only hour in the dunya, compared when he sees the akhirah reality. And the vice versa is the people of the Jannah. فَيَقُولُ رَبُّ يَا مَلَائِكَةِ, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed the angel, اغْمِسْ عَبْدِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ غَمْسَةً, dip my slave in the Jannah for a moment. فَيُغْمَسُ فِي الْجَنَّةِ غَمْسَةً, and then he will be dipped into the Jannah for a moment. Just a second. After he will be brought forth before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will be saying him, Ya Abdi, amarra bika bu'sun qattun, hal marra bika bu'sun qattun, O my slave, have you ever experienced in the dunya from the hardships and the trials and the difficulties and the problems? Because the dunya for the believers is a prison. It's a prison. For the believers, the dunya is a prison. And for the kuffar, it is a jannah. So the believers, of course, has to go through the trials and the tribulations and the hardship and the difficulties. It's not easy to wake up for the fajr. It's not easy. It's difficult. You sacrifice your salah. You sacrifice your beautiful sleeping. It needs the sabr. Wallahi, it needs sabr. And I don't know what's happened to our Muslim societies and the parents, subhanAllah. This holidays time, 2 weeks, at least they can bring the children to the Fajr Salah. I'm telling you, my local masjid, there's a boy, 14 years old from the Pakistani background. 14 years boy. And he's not the imam of the masjid. His father, mashallah, he's called father of the taqwa, father of the righteousness. Whenever I'm there, I see this father, he brings his child, this 14 years old or 15 years old, come, and his recitation, mashallah, Allah gave him so much sweetness in his tilawa. The masjid imam, they allowed him to do the imamah for the Fajr song. And the beautiful recitation, you cannot believe. And I personally did not listen to such a recitation in my life until now. The beauty of that, and this boy only 14 years old. Now you can imagine the father and the son both together coming to the Fajr. And this son, mashallah, he has given the imamah when the imam is there in the masjid and leading the Salatul Fajr.
two rak'ah, which salah of the sunnah, khayru min ad-dunya wa fiha, better than the entire dunya and what it consists. Well, I felt jealousy to see this brother, young brother, so beautiful recitation, coming to the fajr, leading the salah. And behind him also, people who are better in him, in terms of the knowledge and other things, but because of the Quran, Allah gave him. And we sometimes think, if I wake my children for the fajr salah, it's hurt for him. It's not nice for my child. You are actually not helping your children. Especially these holidays times. Time is free, everything we are wasting. Parents has no concern. Heedless about the good and the goodness of their children for the dunya and the akhirah. Wallahi, see this father, how happy he is. This is how Allah described. رَبَّنَا هَبْلَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا رَبَّنَا هَبْلَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنْ وَاجْعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. Oh Allah, give us gift from you of the spouses and the children and the zurriya who will be reason, the cause for our eyes of tranquility. When I see this boy, our eyes become tranquil. How his father will feel? Can you imagine how beautiful it is when this father will be given a Tajul Waqar, the crown of the honor and the dignity on the Day of Judgment, made his child Hafiz al-Quran. So the point here, my dear brothers, so in the dunya you have to go through the difficulties, hardship, to make your child recite Quran, memorize Quran. You need to sabr and musamara. You need to give the time to your children. You have to sit down with them. You need to be your friend. You should be the best friend of your child as a father. If you are not, your child will pick up someone as a best friend who are engaged with the drugs, or the group fightings, or the gangsters. Well, that is the truth. We don't give the quality time to our children, neither we become their best friend. And then when the time is too late, we just has complained. Run and they now start looking for some du'as and the ta'widat. Wal'iyadu billah. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked this man, Ya Abdi Hal Marra Baka Bu'usun Qattun, O my slave, did you find any difficulties, hardship in the dunya to obey Allah, to pray salah, to be in the path of the mustaqim, on the path of the istiqamah? Every hardship he went through, every difficulty he went through in the dunya to obey Allah and His Messenger, because of him being dipped in the Jannah for a second, he will forget everything. He said, Ya Rabbi Ma Marra Bi Bu'usun Qatt. Oh my Rabb, I never knew what is boast all about. I never knew what is difficult is all about. These people of the trench, for whom the people make a huge trench and put them all into the fire and kill them all because they say, Amanna bi Rabbil Alameen. We believe in Allah, the Lord of the universe. While the king was claiming himself, Ya Rabbul Alameen, I am the Lord of the universe. They did not compromise, did not give up their iman. They rather preferred to be thrown into the fire, to be tortured in the fire. They preferred to be sold, to be put on their neck and to be their body to be half into pieces. Yet they didn't give up the Tawheedullah, didn't give up the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They went through these difficulties and hardship. They went through persecutions and the murders. Yet being dipped in the Jannah for 1 second, they will forget everything. So ya ibadallah, ma qimatu na'imin nihayatuhu jahannam. What is the value of the ni'mah that you think is a ni'mah? You are looking behind in the dunya, but it will end in eventually will lead you to the hellfire. What is the benefit of that blessing? In one of the beautiful occasions, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us this story in the Muslim and the Bukhari. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will decree for the people of the Jannah, Jannah, and for the people of the Jahannam, Jahannam. And he will take from the Jahannam everyone who ever said, La ilaha illallah. Min qalbihi, from his heart, and did not commit shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe he been in the hellfire for the major sins that Allah didn't forgive. And he will take them all out from the Jahannam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put them in the Nahr al-Haya, the river of life, because they are skins was blackened in the hellfire out of the punishment. When they'll be thrown in the Nahr al-Haya, the river of the life, they'll be again be fresh, beautiful, and they'll be entering Jannah. One man, last man who will be entering the Jannah, he is the last man coming out of the hellfire and the last man entering the Jannah. This man will be facing the Jahannam, just in the border of the Jahannam. وَقَدْ قَشَبَهُ وَجْهُهُ النَّارُ. The hellfire has rotten his face. And then he will be saying, Ya Rabbi, O my Lord, أَخْرِجْنِي. Let me out of this Jahannam. Just outside of the Jahannam, not in the Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be saying, O my slave, will you going to give me promise if I let you out of the Jahannam, just outside, and then you will not ask me anything? He will say, Ya Rabbi, I gave you promise. And then he will be outside facing the Jannah. And he will see the Jannah and the beauty of the Jannah from that long distance. وَإِنَّ رِيحَهَا لَيُوجَدُ مِنْ مَسِيرَةِ كَذَا وَكَذَا. Rasulullah says, the fragrance of the Jannah and the wind from the Jannah and the beauty of the Jannah, you can smell it, you can feel it from the long distance. He's not yet in the Jannah, outside of the Jannah. He'll see, and then he'll be having patience for some time because he remember he gave promise to Allah. And then after a while he'll be saying, Ya Allah, make me close to the gate of the Jannah. He see the gate. In the Hadith Muslim, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إنما بين مصراعين من مصاريع الجنة مسيرة أربعين سنة. The gate itself, and it has a awdah, meaning the strong part of the gate that holds the gate itself, not the gate itself, the part that holds the gate. He said, this part of that gate is the length in the width is like the distance of the 40 years. If you are to ride 40 years, how much you can go? Can you imagine? That is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala us, أَعْدَدْتُ لِعِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحِينَ فِيهَا مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنْ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطْرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ قَبْ. I have prepared for my righteous of the servants, Ibad, what never, no eyes ever seen, no ears ever heard of, no human beings that they can ever comprehend the nature and the beauty of the Jannah ever. If the adda of the Jannah is the distance of the 40 years of driving yourself going through, what is the gate of the Jannah itself? What is the Jannah itself? Labinatum min dhahab. Ishabi asked Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, hadith in the Bukhari and the Muslim, Ya Rasulullah, ma bina'uha, what is the structure of the Jannah? He says, Labinatum min dhahab. The structure of the Jannah is a brick. Each brick of the Jannah is from the gold. وَلَبِنَةٌ مِّنْ فَضَّةٌ. And another brick from the silver. وَمِلَاتُهَا الزَّعْفَرَانِ الْمِسْكُ الْأَثْفَرِ. In another narration. And the bonding, the mixing of the cement, the bond between the two bricks is a beautiful scent of a musk, the pure. وَحَصْبَاؤُهَا اللُّؤْلُؤُ وَالزَّعْفَرَانِ. And the pearls and the stones on the Jannah, they are the beautiful pearls. And the women of the Jannah, الْيَاقُوتُ وَالْمَرْجَانِ, the rubies, all these things, smile of beauty. So all this beauty, the person, he can feel it and he say, Ya Allah, make me close to the Jannah. I will not ask you anymore. And Allah will be saying, مَا أَغْدَرَكْ. Ma akhdarak, how you can be so treacherous and so breaching your promise with me that quickly? If I give you and make you close to the Jannah, would you promise me you'll not ask me anything else? He said, Ya Allah, I'll promise you I'll not ask you anything else. And Allah will put him there by the door of the Jannah. And then he sees the real Jannah. Fayasbiru ma shaa Allahu an yasbir. He will have the patience as long as Allah wants. He is thinking, I have promised to Allah, I cannot ask quickly. But at the end he could not. What he sees of the Jannah, he could not. If you cannot waiting for the iPhone 7 and 7 plus, all these things. And wallahi, wal Jannah, you cannot even give example of the dunya. Anything. And then at the end he asks, Ya Allah, adkhilni al-Jannah. Just let me enter Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be saying also, Ma akhdaraka ya abdi. How come you quickly you can breach the promise with me? And at the end, Allah fadahik, Allah subhanahu will laugh. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love, Allah's love is like Allah's love, not compared with anyone. And Allah knows only how it is. And we'll see inshallah, inshallah, in the Jannah. What are the beautiful dua? Rasulullah, he taught us, Allahumma inni as'aluka ladhdhat an-nadhr ila wajhik wa ash-shawqa ila liqa'ik. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I ask you to see the taste of looking at your face, the majesty. Ya Allah, hijabuhu an-nur. Allah's hijab is what? Nur. Allah himself, no one can see in the world, in the dunya. No one. Musa asked, could not see. Rasulullah went to the Mi'raj and he been asked, did you see your Rabb? Qala nurun anna arah. Is a nur, how can I see? So is Allah beyond his hijab? Wa hijabuhu an-nur. Allah's hijab veil is not Allah itself. Is that veil obstructing between Allah and the outer world? Is a nur itself, is a light. Rasulullah, how can I see? لو كشفه لأحرقت سبحات وجهه منتهى إليه بصره من خلقه. If Allah to remove his veil, which is the veil of the nur in another nation now, then wherever Allah's sight goes, this nur of Allah's will burn everything. And Allah's sight goes everywhere. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now imagine how beautiful Allah is. That is the best of the blessing that will be given the people of the Jannah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call them after the decision of the Jannah and Jahannam, when the people of the Jannah will go to the Jannah, Allah will call them. Such a beauty and the amazement, subhanallah. Salamun qawlam min rabbir rahim. Allah will give the salam from him. Salam. Allahumma anta salam. Wa minka salam. Tabarakta ya dhal jalali wal ikram. As-salamu yusallimu ala ahli salami fi dari salam. Subhanallah. Allah himself will give the salam on the people of the Jannah. Not Allah only. Before you, when you are entering the Jannah, the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is waiting to welcome you. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. When the believers will be chased to the Jannah, and the doors will be opened, and they will be entering, and the angels will be saying, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ. Peace be upon you. طِبْتُمْ, you have done the purest of the action in the dunya. فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. Enter the Jannah today for the eternal life. Life never ends. So this man, when he sees all this beauty of the Jannah, all the behavior, ask Allah to make him enter the Jannah. And Allah at the end, when he will be laughing to him, he will give him Jannah. And he say, يَا عَبْدِ تَمَنَّى. Oh my slave, ask whatever you want. He will be asking for things. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another version says, يَا رَبِّ يَا عَبْدِ أَتَرْضَ أَنْ يَكُونَ لَكَ مِثْلَ مُلْكِ مَلِكٍ مِنْ مُلُوكِ الدُّنْيَا. Do you okay to have the kingdom like the kingdom of the king of this dunya? I'll give you. He said, Ya Rabbi Radit. He said, oh Allah, I'm happy, more than happy, because he knows what is hellfire all about. Now he's happy to have the kingdom. And the biggest kingdom in the dunya you can even imagine. Like the Harun al-Rashid used to have the biggest kingdom. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, Walaka bimith. 5 times he said, for you, likewise, another kingdom. 5th time, when Allah will be saying, Ya Rabbi Radit. Oh Allah, I became happy, because out of happiness he could not control himself. You see? And another version says, when Allah will be saying, Laka bimithli amthali dunya asharata mirar. For you, like the dunya, 10 times of the dunya of the Jannah. 10 times of the dunya. This is the lowest person and the last person going to the Jannah. One of the people of the Jannah, Al-A'la, Al-Firdaus. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about them, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ غَرَسْتُ كَرَامَتَهُمْ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ عَرَبْتُ وَغَرَسْتُ كَرَامَتَهُمْ بِيَدِي وَخَتَمْتُ عَلَيْهَا. They are the people Allah has chosen them. Allah wants them, these people. Subhanahu Jalla Jalaluhu. And then, when Allah will be telling me, I give you the 10 times of the dunya, 10 times of the dunya in the Jannah, is one Jannah. He'll be saying, أَتَسْخَرُ بِي وَتَضْحَكُ وَأَنْتَ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. The hadith in the Muslim. Ya Allah, are you joking with me? Are you laughing at me?
When somebody sees this thing, this man, he knows what is hellfire and he experienced these things. Now Allah gave him 10 days of the dunya of the Jannah. Subhanallah. Can you imagine now? And then Allah will let him go into the Jannah. And the people of the Jannah, my dear brothers, nowadays the youngsters, they think every day has to go to the gym. It's good, mashallah, exercising. And they're looking for the bodybuilder, 6-pack or 7-pack or 9-pack, Allah knows better what his pack is. All these things you are saying about, soon you die, mashallah. Fi bayti turab, fi dhulumati. You will be the food for the worms. Will be the food for the worms in the grave. This beauty body. But in the Jannah, Rasulullah s.a.w. telling the hadith in the Bukhari, in the Muslim. Beautiful hadith. يَدْخُلُونَ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ الْجَنَّةِ People of the Jannah will enter the Jannah. فَلَا يَبُولُونَ They will have no urination in the Jannah. وَلَا يَتَغَوَّطُونَ No defecation. وَلَا يَمْتَخِطُونَ They don't need to clean their nose because everything pure, not contaminated. أَمْشَاطُهُمُ الذَّهَبُ Their comb will be from the gold. Their comb will be from the gold, my dear brothers. And the Rasulullah s.a.w. telling this, that the structure of the person of the Jannah, hay'a his structure, Subhanallah, 60 dhira'an, 60 dhira'. Dhira' means an arm. Yesterday when I was, I looked this hadith so many times, but I'm just trying to see how much is 60. And I took my tape measurement. And I see 62, I converted in the internet, it comes 42 meters. And I go, I'm checking how much is the 42 meters in my tape. And I see in the tape first, in the written, is whole tape is 3 meters. Whole tape is 3 meters that long. 42 meters length. Ala sab'ati adhra. And the width will be 7 arm and arm length. Meaning each arm is about 2 to 2.5 feet. Is a 42 centimeter length, and about here will be about 20 to 25 centimeter length. That huge body Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them. And for them is the Hurul Ayn, all these things, and the time is flying. I know you are also flying, you can't finish. But for that, what we need to do, my dear brothers, is action in the dunya. U'iddat lil muttaqeen. That Jannah is prepared for the people of the muttaqoon. Righteousness. وَعِنْدَهُمْ قَاصِرَاتُ الطَّرْفِعِينَ And also not this one. When they enter Jannah, for them is waiting their beautiful women in the palace. Beautiful. قَاصِرَاتُ الطَّرْفِ Their gaze always lower. They never ever look to any other man than their husband. Never ever. You cannot find a righteous woman in the world that never looked to any husband once in her lifetime. But the women of the Jannah will never look such a purity. Urban atraba. Subhanallah, the beauty of that Arabic explanation of Allah. Urban is called aruba. Al-mar'atu allati tatafannan fi lughatiha, fi idhar hubbiha, wa ishqiha, wa jamaliha, wa gharamiha. I could not translate because there are so many youngsters here. And atraba, their age will be same. And you can see their beauty beyond their bone marrow. Inside, you can see this beauty. Inna ansha'nahunna insha'a faja'alnahunna abkara. Subhanallah. Allah made them abkar. One of the greatest of the mufassirun al-mujahid, he was saying abkar means kullama ya'ti ila zawjihi wajadaha bikra. Every time he goes to his wife, he'll find her bikr. Not needed translation for the youngsters. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling about them, إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ فِي شُغُلٍ فَاكِهُونَ Indeed the muttaqoon, they are in a business of the enjoyments of the Jannah. From Abdullah ibn Abbas and the Sa'id ibn Musayyib, so many mufassirun, they say, means شُغُلُهُمْ فِي افْتِضَادِ الْبَكَارَةِ Subhanallah. زوجنا الله وإياكم الحور العين. But we need to do action in this dunya. They are the راضيات. سبحانه جل جلاله. May Allah give us tawfiq. The reason of these today's khutbah, my dear brothers, whatever we are doing in this dunya is nothing. It's just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, if you dip down your hand in one finger in the ocean, you bring back your finger, how much water you got? Likewise, the dunya compared to the akhirah, nothing. Million years goes by, you are dead. You are always abna'u thalath wa thalathina sana. You are the children of the 33 years old forever. You and your father, your grandfather, great-grandfather, since the other, everybody is 33 years old. Children and the father, everybody is 33 years old. Subhanallah. Jurdan murdan kihalan mukahalina. Jurdan murdan biyadan. They are be jurd. Means no hairs in the whole body. Murdan, no hairs in the face. Biyadan, subhanallah, beautiful, whitened. And every Jumu'ah, there's a souq, special market. The people of the Jannah will go there. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be coming down to them. And they will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many years will pass by to see the beauty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And Allah subhanahu will be saying that, أُحِلُّ عَلَيْكُمْ رَضْوَانِي فَلَا أَسْخَطُ عَلَيْكُمْ أَبَدًا. Today, I implore and impose my satisfaction and the pleasure upon you. I will never be angry to you. I will never show my wrath. Then the people of the Jannah will be content and happy. Because they will be always thinking, are they going to be out of the Jannah? Allah will kill the death of the death in front of the people of the Jahannam and in front of the people of the Jannah and say, Ya Ahlal Jannah khuludun la mawta fiha. O people of the Jannah, ever eternity life, no death. Wa ya Ahlal Nar, O people of the Jahannam, khuludun la mawta fiha. O people of the Hellfire, eternity there, no death ever. Subhanallah, no, never. And when they meet on the Jumu'ah marketplace, and فَتَخُبُّ رِيحُ الشِّمَالِ, and then a wind come from the Shimal side, from the Shimal direction, and they will face دَادُو حُسْنًا وَجَمَالًا. This man will be more beautiful, more bright in their faces. When they go back to the palace, and they see their wives, some people say, even our wives there in the Jannah. Your wives will be the queen of the all Hurul Ain. She has given us so much beauty. And she'll be saying, Wallahi izdattum jamala wa baha, that you have increased of the beauty. And the husband will be saying, Wallahi, you also being increased in the beauty and the jamal. So the jamal and the beauty of the Jannah will always increase. And beside, my dear brothers, your beautiful palace. And the tent, one tent for the Jannah, in the Jannah, one tent only is made of pearl. And hollow pearl inside, the light is situna maylan ila sama, the 60 miles to the heavens. One. What about the qasr, the palace itself? Tajri min tahtiha al-anhar, beneath which the Jannah, the rivers flows. The beautiful holidays people, those who choose in this country, I know they choose the lake districts and the Cumbria. You go drive there, you see. You're going on the mountain, top of the mountain, beautiful country road, and the lake, left and right side, and the huge mountain. The beautiful houses. Allah knows the human being what they love. So Allah mentioned all these things in the Jannah. The lakes. Wherever you go, lakes of the pure honey, pure milk, pure wine. Everything is there. Everything is pure, not contaminated. May Allah give us tawfiq to enjoy the Jannah al-Firdaws al-A'la ma'a an-nabiyyin was-siddiqin was-shuhada wa hasuna ulaika rafiqa. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa lisa'il muslimin fastaghfiru innahu huwal ghafur rahim. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ثم أما بعد اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة الفردوس ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب القبر ومن عذاب النار ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن فتنة المسيح الدجال اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين واخذل الكفرة والمشركين اللهم اجعلنا من أهل التوحيد والسنة يا رب العالمين اللهم أدخلنا الجنة بغير حساب يا رب العالمين اللهم أدخلنا الجنة بغير حساب يا رب العالمين اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات الذين شهدوا لك بالوحدانية وبنبيك الرسالة وبأصحاب نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم الولاية. اللهم اختم لنا بالخير يا رب العالمين. اللهم ثبتنا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة. عباد الله، صلوا على البشير النذير. اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأهل بيته أجمعين. عباد الله، وأقيموا الصلاة.
Allah, 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 All